While browsing emulation news the other week, I came across something pretty nifty. Here, just take a look. This is an INEO Flip DS. It's really good at 3DS emulation, but that's not what's particularly interesting here. What's actually interesting is this 3DS XL. Right now, all the files necessary to run this game on the Flip DS are streaming directly from my 3DS XL. Yet, I'm still able to play the game at 5x native resolution using the processing power from my Flip DS. What gives? Well, it's all thanks to a new-ish piece of streaming tech called Artic Base. Artic Base is a homebrew application for 3DSs running custom firmware that allows the 3DS to broadcast its encrypted files for use with a compatible emulator on another device. At the moment, that compatible emulator is a fork of Citra, authored by Pablo MK7, the same person developing Artic Base. Getting it running is extremely easy. After copying the .cia release to my 3DS's SD card, I installed the app using FBI and launched it as I would any other app on the system. From here, there are only two options at the moment, either start the server or exit the app. After the server started, it backs out to the home menu to allow me to choose a game to broadcast. Whether the game's digital or physical doesn't really matter. From there, I just launch Citra on whatever device I want to receive the signal, type in the server address, and it all loads like a regular game. Though, maybe with just a bit longer load times up front. You see, Artic Base functions by sending game data over the server as needed. None of the game files are transferred to the secondary computer's permanent storage. As a result, the first time particular pieces of data are requested in a session could result in slightly longer load times, or some brief stuttering. I don't find it too much of an issue personally. After a minute or so of actual gameplay, everything just kinda smooths out, and it feels no different from playing the files locally. Pablo MK7 is also pretty upfront in their documentation that users should expect some longer load times and will need to grapple with the need for a solid, stable internet connection. Since devices on both sides of the server will actually need internet access to make all this work. Upon hearing all this, you might be wondering, why go through all this hassle? If you have a 3DS, playing games on it is the easiest solution available. Similarly, if you have a modded 3DS already, it's not too much of a hassle to dump game data from the machine, transfer it to an emulator, and play that way without the momentary degraded performance of streaming. Broadcasting files over a server is an extremely roundabout way of playing these games, right? Well, not quite. On both sides of the equation, emulator and original hardware, there are a number of benefits for doing things this way, some of which Pablo MK7 lists on the Artic Base page, but it's all still worth digging into just a bit deeper. And let's start with the emulation side of things. Part of the current problem with emulation centers around some gray areas in legality here in the US. Now, I'm just a humble psychologist, not a lawyer, but as anyone who spent enough time in the emulation space could tell you, the laws surrounding my right to back up my games from my original hardware and play them on another device that I own are not settled. Hypothetically, as long as I'm not distributing my files, I should be fine. But there's no way to know for sure unless I prove my case in court, which is not something either I or other companies are actually itching to do. However, by streaming data from my 3DS instead of dumping my files, I can get around a lot of the counterarguments to emulation's legality. No files are being decrypted here. No files are being moved off of original hardware, and in many ways, this streaming setup is akin to connecting an external display to a Nintendo Switch or turning on PlayStation Remote Play, just with a few more steps and slightly different mechanics. While not something I'm constantly worrying about, this hypothetically more legal usage could be really helpful for libraries or academic institutions who are constantly having to prove the case that they're not trying to promote piracy with their preservation efforts. Beyond the potential legal ramifications, there's also just the practical reality that I can start playing a game on my 3DS while traveling and pick up where I left off on an emulator when I get home without the complicated mess of backing up save files, removing my microSD card, and navigating file systems on both devices. My 3DS XL is leagues more compact than any other dual-screen device setups and takes fewer steps to jump into a random game. Meanwhile, dual-screen emulators, or even my desktop computer, come with much more comfortable control schemes, the ability to play with patches, and the comfort of much bigger, higher resolution displays. It's an incredibly easy way to have the best of both worlds for modern 3DS gameplay, and I'm definitely going to be using it to finally finish that Pokemon Y save file that I stopped playing right before the climax at Geosenge Town. Beyond all that, there's also some extra utility Artic Base provides to various types of devices. Now, since this kind of streaming only broadcasts the files, not the gameplay, devices that couldn't typically run 3DS games still won't have that ability. I tested all this out with my ARM-based Surface Pro 9 and saw the same types of crashes I saw trying to run ROMs natively. Similarly, streaming doesn't enable higher quality gameplay compared to native emulation. My FlipDS still caps out at about 7x native resolution at 13 watts, regardless of my emulation method. But streaming-focused devices or devices with very limited storage options without expansion, like modern base-spec smartphones, benefit greatly from not needing to store 3DS files locally, considering larger games can be a few gigabytes apiece. Streaming also enables quicker setups on those devices. During my tests, I was able to easily quit a game from one device and start the game again on another device without having to restart the server. If you're someone testing multiple devices for 3DS emulation performance, or want to see if a specific game will run well before jumping through all the hoops to dump its files, Artic Base is a really flexible way to make that happen. Just remember that only one device can be connected at a time. If Artic Base continues developing and improving, I could see it being a really powerful emulation tool for the types of devices that would have been a pain to mess with previously, or else folks who just want to try emulation before investing a ton of time to set it up properly. Of course, that's all well and good, but I'm sure there are many of you out there watching this who couldn't care less about emulation, since you already have a modded 3DS after all. But y'all could actually benefit quite a bit from this streaming tech continuing to improve. Now, I already mentioned the obvious Switch-like use case of playing on a bigger screen at home, but playing with the device's own controls are a planned feature for Artic Base, which could really sell the vibe of a docked 3DS if done right and implemented in the near future. That alone could allow you additional flexibility in gameplay without giving up the feel of the 3DS's controls, if that's something you're into. However, more importantly, and available right now, is that streaming doesn't require your 3DS to be comfortable to play on at all. Maybe you have broken buttons that no longer feel right, cracked displays that you can barely use for navigation, or even a busted hinge that's causing the upper display to hold on for dear life, if it's even attached at all. Even if your 3DS wouldn't be comfortable to play on by itself, it still has the ability to store games and play cartridges. With Artic Base, it's easy enough to continue making good use of that capability all the way until the 3DS stops working altogether. Heck, if you've been dying to get into 3DS games but don't feel like paying the increasing prices for used consoles in great condition, having the ability to stream games could give you a ton of freedom to buy something damaged and still have a great time if you happen to find a good deal. Plainly speaking, having the ability to turn a 3DS into a game server has the potential to keep many more damaged consoles out of the trash, even if users don't have the skills to properly fix them. With that in mind, I'm not here to oversell Artic Base, no matter how nifty I think it is. It's still very much a work in progress, considering its first release was just a few weeks ago. On degraded connections, like my Pixel 8 Pro's hotspot, I found performance to suffer quite a bit in terms of resolution, responsiveness, and stability. If you don't have good internet available, Artic Base won't be a good option for you. Plus, Citra's own performance issues for certain games don't seem to be smoothed over by this setup. Basically, don't expect streaming to be a magic bullet that's suddenly going to make emulation compatibility on par with original hardware. Heck, it's not even quite on par with local emulation at the moment, since it can't play DLC or homebrew apps. From that perspective, certain games that are great to play through Citra right now, like Stretchmo, are completely unplayable and make this service a little bit worse for wear. Even still, beyond those minor hiccups, no part of my experience so far has been a deal breaker. Even if development ceased right now, this would still be a fantastic setup that I wouldn't hesitate to use going forward in situations that called for it. And if you personally go into using Artic Base, knowing its limitations and setting yourself up for success, I'm certain it's also going to be a powerful emulation tool for you to have in your back pocket. Those are my thoughts though. Now's the time when I ask for yours. Have you already tried Artic Base and have thoughts of your own, or are you someone interested in testing it out but has some questions about how to get started? Let me know down in the comments. As always, if you found this video interesting or informative, go ahead and give it a like to let me know. Then get subscribed for more dual screen gaming videos in the very near future. To go check out Artic Base for yourself, check the link in the video description. I'll also have an extra blurb about tools to back up your games and save files, which you should really be doing before using a tool like this that's reliant on streaming your files. Also, if you're someone looking for a dual screen emulator to use with Artic Base, definitely check out my recent dual screen hardware roundup, as well as my review of the iNeo Flip DS. I'll have links to both of those on the screen and in the description. That's going to be all for this video though. Thank you so much for watching all the way until the end. Until next time, catch you later.